energy and to, again, to feel good and to nourish your body rather than poison your body with lots of things that, you shouldn't be eating anyway. We shouldn't be eating. And most of them are advertised as weight loss strategies.
Oh, that's very interesting because so yesterday, casually, I have seen a video on YouTube about to eat the right food because it's not about diet. And it's so interesting because it was like an aha moment. I said, wow. So yeah. Probably I have to do this too, you know, because I, yes, no, you know why? Because we are women and after 40 years is a certain age when we need
changes in hormones. Yes. But also it completely changes. So obviously we start producing more estrogen.
Yes.
And estrogen is also linked to bone loss. Density loss, that's the one, sorry. And that's why we kind of end up with osteoporosis more than men. However, if you train weight-bearing exercise, strength training, and you actually train with weights,
yeah,
from your 40s all the way into your 80, you are, first of all, you do not lose as much muscle mass as we normally do.
Yeah,
because the older we get, the more muscles we start losing, and that's why we put on more fat. You maintain that same ratio of fat because we all need fat on our body.
Yeah,
we still need fat in our body. Yeah. We don't have to be completely skin and muscle only. That's not good either.
Yeah,
because you know. However, you need to have muscle because muscle is what makes us walk.
Yeah.
And move. If you don't have the muscle, then you end up with injuries. And also the muscle, when you're using your muscles, there is an exchange of calcium between the muscles and the actual bone. But also the bones get stronger if you have a stronger muscle. So
yes. So when I saw that video, I thought, oh my God, so it's an aha moment for me. And it's the high time that I have to pay more attention to my food.
Yep.
Now, what I'm eating every single day just to keep my body healthy.
Yep. But also, I think, you know, in terms of calories in, calories out,
yes,
that's actually one of the very few things that is true. If you want to lose weight, you need to use more calories. So you need to increase your expenditure of calories with movements and perhaps not increase your calories intake through food. If you want to drink 2 glasses of wine, that's got more calories than a plate of pasta. So you kind of have to balance that out. So in that sense, that still works, but you don't have to be hung up on, oh, I've just eaten, I don't know, a bowl of cereal. How many calories is that? No, because if that in that bowl, there is fruits, there is like, I don't know, dairy-free yogurt, there is nuts. That's actually, in terms of calories, you might have a little bit more, but that's a good quality of calories. The fruits, you got all the vitamins and minerals.
So we need a combination of the vitamins.
The combination of the good quality that will is there to nourish your body and to make you grow stronger and feel better, rather than high calories content but poor quality. So like a bar of chocolate could also have maybe the same amount of calories than a plate of pasta, but in terms of nutritional value, the bar of chocolate is just full of sugar, tons of sugar.
You know, maybe it sounds crazy, but I never paid attention to
what you eat.
Yes, to my body and to my food, what I'm eating.
Yeah, and it's really important that you do, because the same way as you put your skin, you know, your cream on your skin and you're doing your hair and you're doing your makeup.
Yes.
What goes inside, it's more important. if you want to have glowy skin and you want to have good hair and good nails, then you've got to look at also what goes inside, because that, whatever we ingest is then absorbed into our organs and it will kind of reflect through your skin.
But I think that I'm very lucky because I don't drink alcohol and I don't smoke cigarettes. And yeah. This is a very, very big advantage.
It's huge. Those two things is what ruins people a lot.
Because just take a look at my skin. So I'm 40. I look like my daughter when we walk together on the street. So the people, they think that we are sisters. So, and it makes me, of course, happy.
Of course. Yes.
My heart is blowing. So I have the next question for you. What was the biggest failure in your life, and what have you learned from your failure? Because just we need that to inspire other women.
Okay, so maybe a couple of years back, I would have looked at certain experience that haven't gone the way how I wanted them to go as failure, but I don't look at them as failures anymore. I look at them as experience, learning curves. So they're not, you know, even the breakdown of my marriage, that wasn't a failure.
Okay.
And for me, that's been a massive turning point because it's moved me away from guilt and from the pressure of having to prove to someone that I was worth it something if whatever is it I had, whatever goal that I set in my life, I was able to achieve it. So, you know, it was an experience. It just didn't work out. I still don't know what is the reason of that experience not working out. But I do have also a lot of positive things I can focus on, which is obviously my two children. And the fact that I grew as a person into a slightly better version of myself, I suppose. In those 15 years I was married to my ex, or I don't know, I didn't stay in Italy and I came to London. That could have been seen as a failure, because now I would love to go back to Italy, but I've spent so long here.
Wow.
I find it completely impossible for me to actually, it's nice to go back here and be on holiday there. But for the way how the system, the bureaucratic system and the government works,
it's
a shock to the system. It really is.
It's not organized, it's not structured.
Not at all. So, you know, like my mom, now we lost a dad only in July last year. So my mom is like, come back, make it work here. And I'm like, I can't. So that could have been, can be seen as a failure to going, well, what did I do? Why did I come here 23 years ago? You know, but it's not, it is what it is. I don't see it as a failure anymore.
But
I think
Italy, it's amazing. It's a beautiful country, the nature, yes. The food, everything.
I mean, you lived in the north, right?
Yes.
I will never go and live in the north. Not even
but
if they pay
I have been traveling around all Italy, so I have been the last year.
But if you try to live in the south, it's a completely different story. Yeah, the south is completely different, and I'm not leaving.
I visited Sicilia, so it's amazing, Sicilia.
Yeah, but there they've got other.
Taormina, Catania, Palermo.
Have you been to Naples before?
Sorry.
Have you been to Naples before?
No, I have friends there. I have many friends around all Italy. Mm-hmm. And so I still keep in touch with them. So I'm in love with this country, with the language, yes. With everything.
I'm in love with my country as well, but it's realistically, it's, you know,
Yeah, no, I understand because you have already your life and you have already your children, your work. So it's to understand. Otherwise, if you go back, you have to rebuild everything up. And that's not so easy at this moment, especially in the time of lockdown. But okay, so let's go ahead. So I have another question to you. What was the biggest aha moment after that you have breaked up your marriage? What have you learned when?
That I can stand by myself on my 2 feet on my own. I don't need anyone. And it's actually pretty cool that I have not having to, I can take decision for myself without having to consult anyone. I'm kind of
You are a very strong woman.
that's for sure. That is for sure. Yeah. Obviously, and sometimes I don't feel I'm strong or I don't feel that I'm doing the right thing in that moment. But then it turns out that that thing that I did in that moment, or even when I felt I was on my knees, I was still being strong
Yes.
compared to maybe what other people's, how other
But this
people
is the
would react
advantage of
or
your
would.
experience. This is the advantage of your experience during your marriage. You become a very strong woman from the psychological point of view. So just if I see you, so you are very, very strong. And
Yeah.
that's so important. It
But that's
has
also been a PT and a, you know, I like lifting weights and I like my cardio plus, sorry, my boxing. I have, so when I was young, I used to be a pro for kickboxing. I
Oh,
qualify, yeah, so
wow.
I qualified for the European Championship
Oh
of
my God.
kickboxing. Yeah, but I broke my knee just prior to the event, so I never participate, and that my career ended at 17, 18. Yeah, and
Wow.
previous to that, I did gymnastics at national level as well. So I've always been a sport in sports. My life is sport. I have a my life has got a sorry, my background has always been sports. So it makes you sport, movement, exercise just keeps you, makes
It
you.
keeps you free. It keeps you for
Not
very
just
strong.
physically, but mentally. Yeah. And when you're doing martial arts, you have to be fearless.
Yes.
Even gymnastics, like when you're trying to, you know, like a doing like a, I don't know, a cartwheel on one of those planky thing.
Yeah.
It's quite scary because you can really hurt yourself. And I
But
hurt myself. Yeah.
that's so impactful. I mean, so for another woman's, because it, for me too, sincerely, so I recognize
Yeah,
it.
yeah. I've always been a risk taker, I suppose, from when I was really young. Yeah. I
Yes.
remember my dad taking me up to the rocks and then say, right, now you can dive in into the sea. I was about 5 years old and I've always done it. I've always just jumped in, jumped or climbed the trees or doing all sorts of things that were pretty, I broke a few things along the way.
Well, it's amazing. So you are an excellent example for another woman's who still feel not strong enough. So then you can imagine how much impact can you create on another woman's and how far could you help them just to get out from a bad situation or.
Yeah.
So it's wow.
My only, I definitely have to put it down. My grace have been obviously my job and the fact that I train. So training has been a big thing where it's always been helping me when I was having really bad days. And just yesterday I posted this month I went. On good days, train. On bad days, train harder.
I have seen that. I
It
have seen that on your
really
page.
makes you, it completely clears your mind and you feel the stress leaving your body. And you might not, you know, and it just brings you down maybe to a little bit less stress, so you feel better because you've accomplished something. So I use, and then obviously I try not to, whenever it's possible,
Yeah.
not to eat as much chocolate when I'm having a bad day. But that's something
Yeah.
that I can't always control. But so yeah, so yoga, running, weights, anything that keeps you moving helps. And then at some point I only had two friends, but those two friends, now I've got a little bit more. Those two friends were my angels. They helped me so much at just staying alive. So, and before I met those two friends, I was surrounded by a lot of bad influences and toxic people. So I had to get rid of all of them. And it was a very lonely journey because slowly, slowly, one by one, I had to completely isolate myself from all of these external, and I was on my own. And when you, and being on your own in pain is not great. So I had to learn to accept the pain and honor the pain and even feel the pain, which is tremendously scary and just, it's bad. In fact, I can probably handle physical pain more than emotional pain better.
Yeah, because our emotion, so they are touching everything, our health,
But
our body, and
emotions, all they are is just thoughts of an experience.
yes,
So,
it's our experience, what we are going through, and so it's also our perception.
the
In that
perception of that
case,
experience
yes.
happened in the past, exactly. And then therefore you form a conception of that experience, and you add a thought that then becomes an emotion. But I starting to then go, okay, on that principle, what am I thinking? What am I feeling? Am I feeling sad? Why am I feeling sad? What am I thinking? Is there a, and then I'm trying to use kind of, but this is only something very new that I've only been able to turn the corner for the last couple of weeks, not before, because they've been again. I've been in and out of dark tunnels for two and a half years. You just, you pick up the phone and you call someone, or I stay away from social media when I'm having a bad day, that's for sure. Because it's, or I put the music on and I just start dancing like a
Yeah, but
crazy person inside the
you
house.
need some space to be with yourself.
Oh, I exercise, or I dance. I literally put music on and I just start raving in my lounge or in my kitchen on my own, and I just start, I don't care, whatever it
That's
may.
a very beautiful way just to be with yourself, to connect with yourself, with your inner. A lot of people, they don't are aware of the power of their mind and inner, and because of that, so I named my YouTube channel The Power of Your Mind and Inner. Yes, so because when you are connected with yourself, with the power of your mind and inner, so you realize how strong you are, even if you are alone. And when you go through the pain, through the bad feeling, because you cannot accept the situation, so because you had very good intentions, but your partner gives you
Had
or
a different
Yes,
agenda.
created a bad situation that you probably never expected. And that we are experiencing the intensive emotions. But it has formed you, the beautiful woman that you are today. And that's amazing because probably he doesn't realize the fact that he has contributed to the changing of your personality, that you can actually help a lot of women. Because of that, so we are here. And that's so there are so many advantages because of your experience. I know, yeah, I know it's very, very painful. I have experienced the same situation as you know, but that has helped and me and motivated me to become the woman who I am today. And
Yeah.
I'm very proud of myself and I'm very
Yeah,
grateful.
I'm definitely proud of myself.
I'm
By
very,
the way,
very
that's
grateful.
something that I'm only starting to feel, this pride and this it's only been recent, like the last I would say 6 months. Nothing before I was like, oh my God, I'm a failure, I failed. But now I'm not
But I
anymore. I'm
was,
used to that. Yeah.
I want to mention something else, what is very, very important. If we don't experience the failure, we cannot grow. Remember this.
Yeah.
And the failures makes us much more stronger.
Yeah.
And through
Yeah.
your failure, you can create impact and help another people, because so then you can compare that moment when you was failing and the actual moment when you are growing. And that's amazing, because your failure you can transform into power and
Yeah.
to help the people around you. So
Definitely.
that's my strategy through I'm helping another people. So you don't have to be scared because of your failure. So you have to be proud.
Definitely.
Yes. I have another question then, so we will finish. What is your biggest achievement after this experience?
Oh,
After
okay,
this
I've got
pain?
loads. I've got loads. Okay, so I bought him out. I refurbished my flat. So with the help of just one person, I chose every single thing in the flat, kind of from the colors to the wallpaper to whether, and we did it. He did it in how many? Maybe 12 weeks. What did I do? What else did I do? Well, yeah, I did my level 4 in the sports performance all
Wow.
throughout lockdown. Established my online business, started Bold Heart.
Wow.
Managed to take my kids still on holiday, even though, rebuild my savings account from zero to a little bit, slightly more, and been able to pretty much pay everything by myself and take my kids to Italy, both in 2019. And then last year, back in lockdown, we were able to come to get to Naples on time, and just get them to do various experience, like, I don't know.
The connection with coaches or with the entrepreneurs around
Yeah.
the world, and this
Yeah.
is amazing. This is so powerful.
Yeah.
Well, because when you connect with another people, you create the possibility not only for you but for another people to motivate and to inspire them. And we are creating possibilities for them, for another people.
Yeah.
And
Yeah.
that's what I think that we have to be grateful for that.
Yeah. So then they're not being just stuck in a flat in South London.
Yes.
I've been able to take them, even if it's just in Naples,
Yeah.
out of the country, by the seaside, or at my mom's house, enjoying grandmother's food and being surrounded by my family, because I've got a huge family. Like, even though it's just me and my brother, but I've got tons of cousins, and we're all like brothers and sisters. And I still have my grandpa, my granddad is still alive. We lost the grandma only 2 years ago. And then obviously we lost a dad last year, but I still got a granddad, so which is the same one that raised me. So he's like my dad. So I still have got a dad and a mom somehow. I had two dads, two moms, and now I've still got one dad and a mom. Just they're all,
Wow.
yeah. Yeah. So in a way, it's kind of, I'm not, it's not all lost. And I don't know, every time I go, things I'm able to offer them experiences within Naples, you know, with people from Naples. I take them kayaking. I've taken them.
Wow, it's so beautiful.
So we always by the seaside with them in summer.
What is your giveaway for another people so who will watch after this interview? What could they learn from you, do you think, in your opinion?
Okay, so that when thing is find what you enjoy to do in life and make it as your downtime. Like, you have to literally schedule in some kind of time for yourself. I was the first one that I always gave pieces of myself and energy, and then I depleted myself.
Yeah.
And in order for me to start feeling better, I had to start finding things that I enjoy doing and making them happen, if it's just, even if it's just 20 minutes or 30 minutes. For me, it's easy. Exercise, obviously, you can do so much in 30 minutes, or dancing. But also seeing friends, schedule to see friends. There is maybe, I can only count the friends that I like, that I really enjoy spending time with on one hand. And I think I have plenty of friends. I have so many more friends, but the one that really matter, the one where I can be myself even on the worst day ever. And when I see someone, one of them, it recharges me. So that's the things that you need to do, and that they will help you to feel better about yourself. And then you then slowly, once you start feeling better about yourself, you find that passion and drive. And again, my job is also a big help because I love what I do. So at least I can just, when I'm having a bad day and my friends are nowhere to see you, I don't want to exercise or anything, I just, you know, I start reading about, I don't know, exercise, or the benefit of exercise, or the psychological benefit of exercise, or, you know, all of these things.
With another word, self-love and self-care is so important. Just
yes.
To
yeah, no, no, self-love, self-care. That's the one. Yeah, that's
yeah.
what it is.
To learn to love yourself and to take care.
But when you're coming from a place where you don't know what you want, because you don't know who you are anymore, because you don't love yourself anymore, it's really difficult. So you need to kind of start from your hobbies and what maybe and you enjoy doing. And sometimes it's just one thing, and you just have to become like repetitive with that thing until you then find something else. And then it's like waking up the child in you that it's been long forgotten.
You know what I realized? That sometimes we forget to make happy ourselves.
Yeah. And it's all about making that child,
yes,
the inner child, happy again.
Yes, so. Yes, because we need that. Sometimes I feel sad, and then I thought, okay, what I'm doing wrong? Why I'm sad? So it means that I have to change the routine just to make myself happy. And I always have been very, very active. I'm a proactive person like you. I have been dancing for 10 years long in all Netherlands, Belgium, and other countries. And then I got back problems, so health issues, and then I must stop.
Right.
That made me very, very sad and demotivated, because I truly loved that. It was my hobby, but I was so happy with that. So because my network, so with many countries, with people around, and the appreciation of the people that made me so happy. And that's, you know, I think that I was missing that. And
yeah,
that's the reason why sometimes I felt so sad. But then I have found it another hobbies, which makes me happy. So by this way, I want to thank you from the depth of my heart that you have taken the time and that you are here with us. and that you have shared your life story and your life experience. I have learned a lot from you. If you have a website or a video or an ebook, you can share with me and I will share it on YouTube.
Yeah,
then
that's
the
awesome.
Then the people can book you or they can keep in touch with you. And
yeah.
I would like to invite my subscribers to like and to subscribe and to share our interview. And take care. And yes, love yourself much more than usually.
Thank you. Okay. Thank
and
you
I
so
will
much.
Invite you so the next time for my Global Life Forum. It was
yeah,
my pleasure.
I'm looking forward to that. I'm really looking forward to that.
Yes, it
well,
was.
I'll send you the details on
yes.
On the message.
Yes.
And,
it was a huge pleasure.
Can I have the recording as well of this interview?
Yes, yes.
So
it was
I'll,
a pretty
I'll post it. Yeah, I'll post it on my I'll
yes.
post it on my social media too.
So it has been a very huge pleasure to having you here, and I see you soon. Bye bye. Take care.
Ciao, Bella.
Bye.
Ciao.